Okay, so this one is by way of a spiritual song, not any particular tradition, although it comes from one very identifiable source, though those of you who identify it, it's cool, but the message is, I think it's a good one. But I have to say, it comes from so long ago so that when it says not to worry about the food you eat, there was no thought about GMOs or things like that in the author's mind, okay? It didn't mean eat bad things. It meant you will be provided for. Really loud to you? It's okay? It's all right? It's all right.
It's okay.
All right, so it's a ready. Okay.
Your maker for the
Ginger's joining me in less than 2 weeks, and I'm thrilled to pieces. I gotta tell you, it's been a long month and a half, or whatever it's been. So she's going to spend about a month, 5 weeks with us over here, and that'll be fun. We'll all have lots of fun. Anyway, I wrote this song. She liked it an awful lot. But we both recognized the irony that was contained within its central message, because it's called Staying Home With You, and here I am not staying home with her, but I'm here with you. So we both knew that was kind of a likely consequence of my having written the song in a way. Song I wrote for Grace in the band that I had called The Great Society.
Yeah.
She sang that in the band, of course, and then she sang it in the Jefferson Airplane for about 5 years. They did it everywhere they went. So, and it was actually I'm sorry, this is the next passing that I'm celebrating, and that's Paul Kantner, who left us this year. Yeah.
Yes.
And Paul, it wasn't somebody he loved so much as this song I'm about to do that caused him to keep calling me and asking me to write songs for them, which with varying results. Anyway, he loved this song a lot. He thought this song was pretty cool. And some people consider this the first, what do you call it? No, it's like there's a new, dark wave. It's like the first dark wave song. Yeah, but somebody said that. It was a dark wave performer writer guy told me that. So. This break. Is that okay with you? Can you hand me one more song before you break? All right. So this is a song that I remembered. It's on my list, but I didn't see it, okay? Because my eyes are not working very well, so I'm so sorry. These are actually cheaters. They're not just like, I'm not just hiding behind them. I'm looking through them. they have magnification in them.
So
this song.
Yes, they are.
Really? multiple meanings. You can't understand it at all. What starts out so big can suddenly seem quite small. And is the poet's heart involved? Or is this some elaborate kind of stall? He's got multiple meanings. You can't understand it. And funerals, you always independently know the weather. But it's not clear if you've been set free or attached to some exotic new kind of tether. And maybe if it's a tether, then you're the ball, and the rope only helps you not fall. It's got multiple meanings. You can't understand it at all. Well, Franny, if the ride don't catch you, maybe the romance will. And what this guy is selling, does it come out of a joint or a whiskey still? Meanwhile, we're marching towards some ad man's mad fall. And Holden's left holding the ball. He's got multiple means. You can't understand it at all. Are you holding, man? Got lions and searchlights and sailors all dressed in red. It's got the elixir of youth shaken with the bitters of dread. It's got an intense longing for more and all the comfort of knowing you're a whore. It's got multiple meanings and God damn it, I can only understand four. The phrase too much information nearly always means of some specific kind. There's no such thing as too much when it comes to the staggering leaps we laughingly call the mind. Why, this song's got whatever holds you in thrall, and it's even got your freedom's call. It's got a multiple meanings, you can't understand it at all. Make a little game out of each new phrase I say. And I'll bet you $10 you can't guess the next word I'll play. And if you start making too many right calls, they'll just induct you into the imitators hall. He's got multiple meanings, you can't understand it at all. Well, party of the saints are flashing rhythms, but the lords are following their appeals. Over there on the right, animal is elephants are determined to seal the deal. And at the banks and astrologers call, they'll round us up and herd us down to the mall. It's got multiple meanings, you can't understand it at all. Anybody from Region 3 tonight? It uses nearly every muscle the mind can flex. It's got cracking, yes, baby. It's even got anal sex. It's got Jesus and the Buddha, too. All locked up in Reverend Cohen's zoo. It's got multiple meanings. I'd be delighted to share several dozen with you. Meanwhile, some of us are having a ball, but for some of us, it's too close to call. It's got that many meanings. Maybe it means nothing at short break, and then I'm going to come back and talk at you a bit, and you know, you can talk at me, and we can see what happens, and try to sell some stuff. And then I'm going to be joined by the maestro Terry Haggerty, and we're going to play a bunch of more rock and roll-ish kind of tunes. Thank you. Don't forget, we have some posters tonight. Only $5. $5 each, 2 for $10. And I have a feeling you'll go fast, and Darby and Terry will autograph them for you, so come see me if you want to buy one.
This incredible book is for sale. It's a brand new book, but it's like published, I think, a few years ago. But it's an amazing history. They're for sale now if you want to get them during the intermission. And also the songwriter sketchbook is available right now if you want to come up and get one. This beautiful woman will sell them to you right here. Okay, so the book is, I think, $30. Okay, so the books are for sale, and the CDs are for sale as well. Or is it a DVD? CD, I'm sorry. The CDs for sale, books are for sale right now. Okay, thank you. And he'll autograph them for you after the show.
What's that?
I'll buy you one if you buy me one.
I need my glasses to look at it. How much are they?
They're 30 or 2 for 50.
Okay, I'll let you know.
Rembrandt, and therefore, you were about to say where you learned it from.
So I, you know, I,